In this video, we'll go over the basics of the ribbon control, starting with its general settings and moving on to specific elements. I already have an application with the nav bar control on the left and the rich edit control here in the middle. Let's drop a ribbon control and ribbon status bar from the navigation and layout tab from the toolbox onto the form. The ribbon control is automatically docked to the form's top and the status bar is at the bottom. Next, I'll click the ribbon control's smart tag and convert its parent form to ribbon form. This form is specially designed to display ribbon control-based UIs. For example, you'll notice the form's maximize, minimize, close buttons are located within the ribbon's header, not within the form's header. You can also change the ribbon style from the smart tag. Let's change it to the modern Office 2013 style. Find out more about different ribbon styles in our documentation center. A ribbon control's elements are divided into page categories, pages, page groups, items, and item links. If you right-click on the ribbon control, you'll see here that you can choose which element you want to add. Pages are tabs with headers, and clicking a header activates a corresponding page. Pages contain page groups, and page groups contain item links, which take you to items. Each item within a ribbon control can have several links to itself. To add an item link to a page group, select the group, right-click it, and choose your menu item. Here I'll choose Add Button. Quickly modify each element by clicking its smart tag. Let's rename our pages and page groups. I'll name the pages Insert and Home. In the home page, I'll create two page groups named Clipboard and Alignment. In the Item Link smart tag, we can name each item, select the ribbon style, and choose glyphs for images. I just created the cut item. Now I'll do the same and create one for copy as well. Now I'll create a menu item, name it Paste, select a large ribbon style, and choose the appropriate image. With menus, you can also create submenus. Here, I'll create two submenus and include the appropriate images. I'll name them Paste and Paste Special. Let's take a look at these menu items at runtime. You can rearrange item links and copy them at design time. Simply drag and drop it to the new destination. To create additional links to this item, drag it with the control key pressed. That's what I'll do here with a cut item. I'll drag it over to the Quick Access toolbar and down to the status bar. Now I'll set some code to handle the click event for the cut item. Let's run the app now and you'll see from this demo that our click event works for all cut items. Now let's look at galleries. I'm going to show you how to use a gallery to include options for the alignment page. Right-click and choose Add Ribbon Gallery Bar Item. This creates our gallery, and inside this gallery, I'll add a group. Inside that group, let's add three items. Each item will align text to left, center, and right. Click the image glyph to include the appropriate image for each selection. I'll add two more items, and notice here how the items keep expanding columns. We can fix this by selecting the gallery and choosing a number for the column count. I'll set it at 3. You can see the changes reflected in the designer. I'll right-click on the gallery and add one more gallery item, and then include images for top, middle, and bottom alignment as well. It's good to note here that you can also choose to show the item's text. And you'll see that it can create larger items and take up more space in the gallery. I'll take the text away and show you how to hover over images now. I'll select the first left item and click its smart tag. From the menu, I'll select the Hover Image glyph. In the Image Picker, I'll choose the larger size and select the appropriate image. I'll do the same for the other 5 alignment options as well. Next, select the gallery and set its Allow Hover Images property to true. Now when we run the application, you can see the larger images appear when I hover over them. I'll go back to Visual Studio and set its item check mode to single check. Run the application again, and you'll see that the item is now selected when I click on it. Now let's look at button groups. They're great for displaying a group of similar options. I'll create a new font style page group where users can change the font to bold, italics, and underline. For this, I'll add a button group with 3 buttons. Right-click on the button group to add the buttons. For each button, I'll choose the appropriate image. Next, set the button style for all links to check. Now, when we run the application, you can see how each button remains highlighted once it's clicked. Next, the top left of each ribbon contains an application button, which displays a menu when you click it. The Office 2007 styled ribbon displays an application menu, while the Office 2010 and 2013 styles collaborate with the Backstage View control. This control can display tabs, buttons, and separators. I'll add 2 tab items and a button command. I'll set the button to act as the close option. The tabs are selectable items which display their content in the right pane. You can drag any control into this pane, and when the tab gets selected, its content is displayed. For this video, I'll place a user control as the recent tab's content. I'll set the docking property to the middle. Next, I'll show you a couple ways you can connect the Backstage View to the application menu. You can select it here in the Ribbon Control Smart Tag, or you can set it from the Properties window. Now, if I run the application and click on the application menu button, you'll see our Backstage View control appears exactly the way we set it up. Now let's look at the runtime features of the ribbon control. End users can minimize the ribbon. Add or remove item links to the Quick Access toolbar. And display the toolbar above or below the ribbon. The Office 2013 style features a full screen mode. In this mode, the ribbon automatically hides when it's not focused. This helps save workspace. I'll go back into Visual Studio and set the ribbon's Allow Customization property to true. This allows end users to customize the ribbon at runtime with the ribbon customization form. Here, I'll create a new tab called Format. And I'll rename the first group Main. Then I'll place the paste command inside the main group. End users can also export their changes to an XML file, and then import them anytime for quick and consistent changes. And there you have it, some basic ribbon control concepts. To learn more, please check out our online documentation. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.